overly confident. So what happens is the media, the coach, the public, and the fans create this massive expectation that because you won the World Cup last time, you're the favorites now. And I'm sure if you asked people before, or people asked you, who's the favorite, most people would have said Germany. So they go into the first game overconfident, and then they got very much like a boxer, a defending champion, a long time boxing champion that got knocked down, like Mike Tyson against Buster Douglas, gets knocked down for the first time in a long time. That knock literally takes the confidence out of them. And they battle to recover. Most never recover. And that's exactly what happens to these World Cup winning teams. Even the German team, they got, when Mexico scored the first goal, the winning goal against Germany in the first game, they knocked out Germany's self-confidence. They knocked out Germany's belief. And all of a sudden, and you could see it yesterday in the game of South Korea, all of a sudden the German team started to freeze because they now realized if they don't win, if they don't make the next round, it's going to be a national disaster. They're going to suffer public humiliation. And remember, this is the greatest fear of the human being. Greater than the fear of death is the fear of failure, and the fear of failing in public and suffering public humiliation. And when that happens, the team literally runs out of ideas. The team freezes and the team cannot perform. And then you get this combination of mistake after mistake. And that's why the defending champion hardly ever make it past the first round. So what is amazing is that at the last Confed Cup last year, Germany fielded a young team, an inexperienced team. The media called it the C team, and went on to win the Confed Cup. And Jogi Löw, the German coach, even came out in public stating that there is no more guarantee for any position in the German team, meaning that the old players would have to work hard. But then what happened is that he defaulted again to fielding the old players, 8 out of 11 from the previous World Cup, because the bond between the old team and the coach is just too strong. So the only way to break that bond is that when you win the World Cup, you have to fire the coach. The first thing you have to do is to fire the coach, hire a new coach with a mandate to build a new team. Because again, if you think about it, it's exactly what happened to Germany in 2006, when they hired, a couple of years before, Jürgen Klinsmann, a new coach that had no allegiance to the old tradition, the old team, who built a new team. And that's a team that went on to come third in 2006, third in 2010, and win the World Cup in 2014. So that's a formula. You need a new coach, you need a new team, you need new ideas. So good luck, and remember, eat well, sleep well, and gym well.